Hello, I'm here with Aura Noir at Hellfest 2016. I'm Hayley Leggs for Total Rock. And it is gloriously hot today, isn't it? Even though it's supposed to be raining.
Yeah, it is. Or is it? I haven't really been outside, so.
Oh, you've been locked in here all day.
Yeah.
At least you have beer. Yeah. It could be worse. So it's been 3 years since the last release. Have you got any more plans to record anything soon?
Yeah, we're talking about going to studio in October, I think. We're making songs at the moment, probably on song number 6, 7, something like that. So record in October and release early next year, I hope.
Have you got ideas?
Yeah, I've got some ideas, but it's a bit early to say. Even if we're we already did 6 songs, so.
Oh, you've got 6 songs planned already.
Yeah.
So just going to wait and see what happens with the rest, get some inspiration.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we basically just need to meet up because like our guitarist Blasphemy lives in Portugal and the rest of us we're scattered around Norway or around Oslo, so we don't get to meet that often. We're not super rich, so we can't afford to meet either, and we don't have a rehearsal room, so we have to take advantage of situations. Like, we played in Portugal last year and we just rented a house for a week while we still were there. And
oh, nice excuse for a trip to Portugal.
Yeah, very nice. And then, yeah, so we have to be all together to finish the songs. We can always make riffs by ourselves, but
yeah. I guess, Norway is probably quite a good place to get inspiration for the dark songs. And Portugal might be a bit hot and sunny, a bit too joyful.
Yeah, I don't know. We just have to be the right minds together, and it doesn't really matter which continent we're on.
Yeah. So over the years, does the lyrical theme kind of stay the same? Are you still going with the same things?
Yeah. We like to keep it primitive. Before we were even more into, at least me, writing, more charming lyrics than good ones.
So like, charming?
Yeah, like, you know, old Sodom German thrash metal and stuff.
Give me an example.
I masturbate to kill myself.
Don't we all?
No, I mean, stuff like that. I think it's charming to listen to. Even if it's silly, it's still good.
I've never heard black metal described as charming. That's lovely. So the Norwegian black metal scene is so big, really, comparatively to every other country. Is there a sense of rivalry between the bands or camaraderie? Do you stick together or are you against each other?
We're kind of split. We are. Because I know the Bergen scene is very different from the Oslo scene, and there's. And even like in Oslo and all of the country is like divided between the bands who like us who want to keep it organic, more old school, and not make use of the modern recording techniques that much. Like when you play the riff one time and then copy paste it throughout the song, we don't like that stuff.
So like recording on an old 1990 tape recorder.
No, it doesn't have to be. You can even record it digitally, but just don't use that. Copy paste and the trigger drums, and we hate all that stuff. So I mean, I'm not interested in more than half of the Norwegian bands, but we are like a clique staying together. I'm more with the Fenris,
So who are your favourite bands of the Norwegian black metal variety?
Yeah, Dark Throne, definitely. And then
are you friendly with them?
Yeah, they're good friends. I grew up, like, they're 2-3 years younger than me, so I saw them at the local cinema in 88 or something. So I've always looked up to them, and I think they still make interesting stuff, you know. And I think they did the best black metal ever with their first releases.
Do you have a title in mind for the new album?
No, not yet.
See how it comes to you. Okay, we're being told to cut the interview short, so sorry about that, but it was lovely to meet you. Thank you very much for talking to us.